Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you how to install Windows 11 on VirtualBox. Starting with version 7.0, VirtualBox started supporting Windows 11 natively. So they implemented TPM and they implemented Secure Boot. So you don't have to modify the Windows 11 ISO before installing it into VirtualBox. Also, I want to show you how to perform this installation in the easiest and simplest way by performing an unattended install with only a couple of clicks within VirtualBox. I'm gonna divide this video in two parts. In the first part, I'm gonna show you how to get the official Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft site. And in the second part, I'm gonna show you how to perform the Windows 11 installation on VirtualBox. So let's start by downloading the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft site. Open your web browser and go to this site, microsoft.com/software-download, and here click on Windows 11. Scroll until you find something called Download Windows 11 Disk Image. This is it here. And click on the drop-down list and then select Windows 11. And then click on Download. And here choose the language you want. For me, I'm going to choose English United States. And then click on Confirm. And here click on 64-bit download so to start downloading the ISO. So I'm going to save it. And now the ISO is downloading. I'm going to fast forward this video and come back when the ISO is downloaded. So now the Windows 11 ISO file is downloaded. And we're going to go to the next part of this video, which is installing Windows 11 in an unattended way into VirtualBox. I'm using here a Windows 11 host PC, but the instructions I'm going to show you will apply to any host that is running VirtualBox. I'm assuming here that you already have VirtualBox installed on your PC. If you don't have VirtualBox installed on the PC and you want to know how to install it, I previously made a video about this. You can check out this video in the link in the description. So let's go now and launch VirtualBox. And in VirtualBox, click on Tools, click on the right menu here, and make sure that you are in Welcome. And then on the right here, click on New. And name the virtual machine Windows 11. And under folder, you can change the path where the virtual machine will be created. I don't want to change it. It is okay for me here. If you want to change it, click on the drop-down list and choose the path you want. For the image here, we need to select the ISO image that we just downloaded. So click on the drop-down menu and then click on Other. And this is the image that we just downloaded. Select it and then click on Open. The next option is to choose your Windows edition. So here in the drop-down menu, choose the Windows 11 edition that you have an activation key for. For me, it is the Windows 11 Home, so I'm gonna leave it at Windows 11 Home. And here you have Skip Unattended Installation. What this means is that if you wanna perform a manual installation, you need to check this box. But here I'm gonna show you how to perform an unattended installation, which is much faster, and it will permit you to create a local user even if you're using Windows 11 Home. So click on Next, and here are the options for the unattended installation. For the username and password, I'm gonna keep them by default. I tried before changing the password and it didn't work. The password by default is ChangeMe, and the username is VBoxUser. And for the host name, notice here that I have a warning. It is because it took the name of the virtual machine that has a space. So let's remove the space, and notice now we have a green check mark. And install in the background, I'm gonna keep it unchecked because I wanna see the progress of the installation. And it's very important to click on guest additions so that this way VirtualBox will install the guest additions that will permit you to put, for instance, the virtual machine full screen, and it will integrate fully like this with VirtualBox. And here you need to put your product key so that Windows will be activated automatically for you. Otherwise, you can put it afterwards after you install Windows. I have a product key for Windows 11 Home, so I'm gonna put it here. And when you make all your choices, click on Next. And on this screen, if your host allows it, you can increase the memory, for instance, for 8 GB and increase the number of CPUs for like 4 CPUs. It will be faster. But here I'm gonna keep it by default like it is. Make sure that Enable EFI is selected and then click on Next. And the same here for the disk size. If you want to increase it, you can increase it. Do not reduce it less than 80 gigabytes. For me, it is okay like this. So I'm gonna click on Next. And this is the summary. And I'm gonna click on Finish. And the installation will start. So notice that the virtual machine is starting. You need to do still one manual intervention. So you need to click into the virtual machine And when this message appears, type anything on your keyboard so that the virtual machine will start from the ISO file. Otherwise, it's gonna start on a prompt and then you have to restart it. So this is now VirtualBox performing the unintended installation of Windows 11. You don't have to intervene, just leave it to finish. Once the initial phase of the installation is finished, the virtual machine will prompt you to restart. You can leave it to restart automatically or click on Restart Now, and the installation will continue after the virtual machine restarts. And all you have to do at this stage is just wait for the virtual machine to continue the installation automatically. So the virtual machine will restart once again. So the machine is setting up the user profile now for the first time. And this is Windows 11 installed. By default, VirtualBox will install Windows 11 so that it will login automatically with the VBox user that was created during the unintended installation of Windows 11. I'm gonna show you how to remove this automatic login so that the virtual machine will prompt you each time to put the password, because this is a very important security measure. So let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm gonna restart the virtual machine and you're gonna notice that it will login automatically using the VBox user. And here it is logging in automatically. To correct this, we need to use Registry Editor. So click in the search box and type in regedit, hit enter, click yes. And here you need to go to HKey local machine and then click on software and then click on Microsoft. Scroll until you find Windows NT, expand it, and then expand current version. And under current version, go to WinLogon. And on the right, you have default username. You need to delete this key, right click on it, and then choose delete, and then click on yes. And now we corrected this problem. Let's demonstrate it. I'm gonna restart the virtual machine. And now you notice that Windows will prompt us to put the password. So we still need to change the password, because change me is not really a strong password. So the password is change me, just put it and log in. And let's change the password. And to simulate Ctrl-Alt-Delete in your VirtualBox machine, you need to press the right Ctrl key with Del, and here choose change a password, and the old password is change me in small letters, and here put a new password and confirm it, and now the password is changed. So let me demonstrate to you that we can put the virtual machine in full screen. So click on view, full screen, and you notice that it goes in full screen because with the unintended installation, we chose to install the guest additions into the virtual machine. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this way you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I want to thank you all for watching and see you in the next video.